Children, welcome to our science session. Let's continue our chapter 10, reaching the age of adolescence. In the last session, we have discussed about role of hormones in initiating reproductive function. That is how hormones we initiate the function of reproduction. That is endocrine glands, which are otherwise called as Douglas glands, release hormones into the bloodstream to reach a particular body part, what we call that as target site. Then once the hormone, if they reach the target site, then target site responds to the hormone. What are hormones? Hormones are chemical secretion secreted by endocrine glands. And there are many endocrine glands or Douglas glands in our body. The testes and ovaries are the endocrine glands. They secrete sex hormones, and the testes, they secrete male sex hormone in male called as testosterone, and ovaries in female secrete female sex hormone called as estrogen. And these hormones, that is sex hormones like testosterone and estrogen, are responsible for the male and female secondary sexual characters. And further, the sex hormones, they are under the control of hormones from the pituitary gland. Isn't it? Pituitary gland controls all the other endocrine gland. That is why we call pituitary gland as master gland. The pituitary gland secretes many hormones, one of which it makes the ova. Ova is otherwise called as egg, to mature in the ovaries. As the same way, it makes the sperm in the form in the testes. That is, it initiate the testes to produce sperms in male organisms. And the same way, we have discussed about role of hormones in completing the life history of insects and frogs. The same way, hormones also play an important role in the life history of insects and frogs. For insects, we have discussed about life cycle of silk moth, and in our frog, how that frog undergo metamorphosis. That is, silk moth, if we have learned about the life cycle of silk moth and frog, where it undergo the process of metamorphosis. That is, what is metamorphosis? It is a process which results in the drastic change in their body, isn't it? And the insect hormones, they control the process of metamorphosis in the insects. The same way in frog, thyroid releases thyroxine, which control the process of metamorphosis in frogs. And the thyroxine, they produce in frog with the help of iodine that is present in water. So from this we understood that iodine is very important for the production of thyroxine. Thyroxine is a hormone produced by thyroid gland, isn't it? If there is lack of iodine in water, then the tadpoles, they would never turn into adult frog. The conversion, the change of tadpole to adult frog is called the entirely different drastic change occurs. This is what we call that as metamorphosis in frog. So for the change of tadpole to frog, what is essential? Iodine in water is essential. The same way, if is iodine also play an important role in a human being? Yes. If people do not have enough iodine in their diet, what will happen? Will they get goiter caused by the lack of thyroxine? Yes, because we know that iodine is very important for the production of thyroxine. Thyroxine is a hormone produced by thyroid gland. Got that? That is why nowadays we get iodized salt. Isn't it? If you see in salt packet, it will be mentioned iodized salt. That is, presence of iodine is very, very essential. So deficiency of iodine causes goiter, that is swelling of neck region. That is nothing but enlargement of thyroid gland takes place. There is a deficiency disease of thyroxine. for production of thyroxine, what is essential? Iodine is essential. So lack of iodine leads to the deficiency disease called goiter. So pituitary hormone secreted by pituitary gland, which includes growth hormone and many other hormones that make other glands like testes, ovary, thyroid, adrenal to secrete their own hormone. So we have learned that pancreas secretes a hormone called insulin, thyroid produces thyroxine, and adrenal gland, which are present on the top of the kidney, they produce adrenaline. And testosterone is a male hormone produced by testes, and estrogen is a female hormone produced by ovaries in female. Now, the reproductive phase of life in human is that reproduction takes place throughout our life? No, we have learned that the ability of production of gametes in humans, they happen only up to certain time period only. The time period varies between males and females. So reproductive phase in females, it begins from the age of 10 to 12 years, and it will last until the age of 45 to 50 years. It is 10 to 12 years, puberty happens, isn't it? The puberty is the ability to reproduce. So when females attain puberty, what will happen? The egg, otherwise called as ova, start getting mature. One of the ovaries, they release the mature egg around 28 to 30 days. That is, once in a month, one egg will be released by any one of the ovary. At this time, the wall of the uterus, they may prepare themselves. That is, they become thick so that they can hold the egg in case fertilization occurs. And then the egg develops. If fertilization does not take place, the lining of the uterus, they shed off along with the unfertilized egg and the blood vessels. This results in menstruation, or we call that as bleeding in female. The menstruation, after menstruation only female is capable of reproduction. So the first menstrual flow occurs at puberty, and it is called as menarche. When the menstrual flow stops, it happens at the age of 45 to 50 years. So this is called as menopause. Pause means stop. So menstrual flow stops at the age of 45 to 50 years. Got children? So this, when the menstrual flow stops, what we call that as menopause. And the first menstrual flow occurs at puberty, what it is called as menarche. The whole menstrual cycle occurs because of female hormones, what we call that as estrogen. So from this, what we understood, the reproductive life of a woman lasts from menarche to menopause. That is, what is menarche? The first menstrual flow is called as menarche. It occurs at the age of 10 to 15 years. That is puberty, once they attain puberty. And menopause occurs at the age of 45 to 50 years. That is when the menstrual flow stops. So this period, in between this period only, we call that as reproductive life of women. And now let us study about how is the sex of the baby determined. What do you mean by that? That is, whether the baby will be boy or a girl. That is, in how it will be determined. Inside the fertilized egg, what is fertilization? The fusion of male and female gamete. Male gamete is what we call that as sperm, and female gamete is egg or ova. Once fusion occurs, it is called as fertilization. Fertilization results in the formation of zygote. So zygote is it will determine the sex of the baby. How? The instruction inside the zygote, the instruction will be there. It is present in the form of thread-like structure, what we call that as chromosomes in the fertilized egg. In chapter cell structure and function, we have learned that the structure of the cell, isn't it? We have learned about structure of nucleus. Inside the nucleus, we have learned that thread-like structure, what we call that as chromatin reticulum, isn't it? That is network-like structure. During cell division, what happens? This thickens to become chromosomes. And so chromosomes are present inside the nucleus of every cell. So here, if you see, all human beings, we have 23 pairs of chromosomes in the nuclei of our cells. So each and every cell have 23 pairs of chromosomes. Pairs means two, two. These two chromosomes, they are arranged in pairs. 23 pairs are arranged. Out of this 23 pairs of chromosomes, only one pair, that is two chromosomes, are called as sex chromosomes. So those two pairs are named as X chromosome and Y chromosome. And in female, one pair, that is sex chromosome, has only two X chromosome. But in male, they have one X chromosome and one Y chromosome. Got children? All human beings, we have 23 pairs of chromosomes. Out of these 23 pairs, one pair is called as sex chromosome. This one pair means two chromosomes will be there, isn't it? Pair means two. In that two chromosome, in male, one X chromosome will be there and one Y will be there. But in female, both chromosomes are X chromosome. Now, the gametes, that is egg and sperm, isn't it? Male gamete, we call that as sperm, and female gamete, we call that as egg. They have only one set of chromosome. In the unfertilized egg in female, isn't it, always has only X chromosome, because in female, X chromosome only present. But in male, the sperms, they are of two kinds. The sperm, either it has X chromosome or it will be having Y chromosome. And see here, you can see the sperm, either it may be of Y or it may be of X. When sperm containing X chromosome fertilize the egg, see here, egg, they have only X chromosome. See, it is in the shape of X. So it is having X chromosome, and the zygote will, here it is a zygote, will have two X chromosome, one X from sperm and one X from egg. So have XX. XX means what? Female. So it develops into a female child. On the other hand, if the sperm contains Y chromosome, and if it fuses with the egg have X chromosome, it results in the formation of X from female and Y from, X from egg and Y from sperm. So it results in the formation of XY. That is, the zygote would develop into male child. So this way, the sex of the baby is determined. Again, let us discuss how sex of the baby is determined. That is, 23 pairs of chromosomes are present inside the nucleus of every human cell. These chromosomes are thread-like structure. They always present in pairs, two, two. That is, pairs means two. The chromosomes help in determining the sex of the child. Out of these 23 pairs of chromosome, one pair, that is two chromosomes, are called as sex chromosome, called X and Y chromosomes. Females have both two chromosomes are X chromosome, but in male, one chromosome is X and one is Y chromosome. The gamete, that is, whether it is male or female, they contain only one set of chromosome, that is either X or Y chromosome. The egg of the female containing, always they have X chromosomes only, but the sperm contain any one of the chromosome, that is either they may have X or Y. So if the sperm contain, we know that during puberty, the testis produce millions of sperms. isn't it? So the sperms, they which carry, either they carry X or Y. So if the sperm contains Y chromosome, they fertilize with egg which contains X chromosome, the zygote develops into a male child. On the other hand, if the sperm contains X chromosome and fertilizes the egg containing X chromosome, the zygote develops into female child. Hence, the sex of the child, it depends on the chromosome of the father, not the mother. Because mother always, we have always mothers have X chromosome only. But fathers, they have either X or Y. So sex of the child depends upon the chromosome of the father and not the mother. For children, now let's proceed about reproductive health. What are the factors that lead to overall well-being in adolescence? It includes healthy diet, physical activity, personal hygiene, as well as no tobacco and alcoholic use. These are all the factors leads to good reproductive health of a human being. And first, we will discuss one by one. First, let us see about healthy diet. That is, the physical and mental well-being of an individual regarded as individual's health. What do you mean by health? Health is one, not only physical, but as well as mental health. To keep the body healthy, we have to, at any age, what do we have? We have to have a balanced diet. What do you mean by balanced diet? A diet which includes all the constituent of food, such as carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals in a adequate quantity, is called as balanced diet. And also, the person must have a personal hygiene and have to undertake adequate physical exercise. So during adolescence, so these factors are very, very essential, because body is growing at the age of adolescence. So now let us start about nutritional needs of adolescence. So adolescence age is the age where rapid growth and development takes place. Hence, the diet of the adolescent has to be carefully planned. Isn't it? Now, just now we have discussed about balanced diet. Balanced diet means the diet which includes all the constituent of food like carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals in requisite proportions. And our Indian meal, it consists of roti or rice, dal means pulses, and vegetables. So it is a balanced meal. And milk, it is a balanced food itself. Milk consists of sugar, fat, protein, everything. So milk itself a balanced diet. And fruit also provide nourishment. And the newborn baby, for it, mother's milk provides the nourishment, whatever they need. So now if you discuss about that, iron builds production of blood, iron is very, very essential. What are iron-rich food like leafy vegetables, jaggery, meat, citrus, gooseberry, Indian gooseberry, it is called as amla. They are all good for adolescents. And if you check your items for your lunch and dinner in your meal, you have to check whether is a meal, whatever you have, is it balanced as well as nutritious? Does it include cereals, which gives energy, milk, meat, nuts and pulses? These are all provide proteins for your growth. And also your diet should include, it has to have some fats and sugar which give energy to us. What about fruits and vegetables? They are also very, very essential, because otherwise it leads to some deficiency diseases. So we can call them as protective foods. And the chips, packed items or tinned snacks, though they are very tasty, you should never replace the regular meals by chips or whatever it is, as because they do not have adequate nutritional value. So you can see here some food item, what are the major nutrients and function. Pulses and nuts, major nutrients, they have protein. Proteins are very, very essential for growth and repair of body cells. Orange and amla, they are rich in vitamin C. They keep the body healthy by providing the resistance. And sugar and roti, or you can see that cereals, they are rich in carbohydrate. They provide energy. Oils in our meal, it includes fats. Fats provide us energy. Vegetables, they have vitamins and minerals which keep our body healthy and disease free. So they call that as protective food. Okay, children, in this session we have learnt about how the sex of the baby is determined. Sex of the unborn child, it depends on whether the zygote has XX or XY chromosomes. And it is very important to eat balanced food and maintain a personal hygiene during adolescence so that we can maintain our reproductive health. That's all for this session. Thank you.